shoulders makes me happy.
What's going on, guys? How's it going? Listening to a little Carly Rae Jepsen there. Jepsen? Yep, Jepsen. Album's called Tug of War. That was Sunshine on My Shoulders. Just kind of listening to some music while I'm getting everything set up. What's up, guys? How's it going tonight? Trying to get a different... I don't even know where I'm going with this thing at the moment. I haven't even thought this thing through at all. Because I'm a little pissed off. I'll get into that here in a second. But yeah, at least I got the TV fucking on today, right? But I had a different logo I was putting up there. I had the had a picture from Studio 117, threw it on the hard drive, put it up there, and it said the resolution was not supported on this fucking TV. So who knows, man? Who knows what's going on, really? Electronics are not my friend currently. What's on my glass? That just came out of the... Just came out of the dishwasher. Like, literally, I pulled it out of the dishwasher about 30 minutes ago. Dishwasher. That's electronic, too, isn't it? Yeah. Electronics, man. They are fighting against me for some reason. So, yeah, let's just jump right into it. So, I got my mic, my new mic over here, the red mic that I showed to you guys a few days ago, a week ago, whatever. Not a month ago. That's a long time ago. Didn't even have it a month ago. But I hooked it up, I put it into this input that this mic is already on, input number one, and then also put it into input number three, which is where I was going to keep it. I was going to keep this one, that one too, like it's always been. I was going to have the red mic on three. When I hooked it up and I plugged it into this mount right here, man, all kind of feedback. I mean, just a big hum coming through there. So I don't know if it's the connection, I don't know if it's the mic. I swear, and I can't remember specifically, but I swear I hooked it up the night that I got it, and I did some mic test with it, and I was real excited that it sounded pretty good. I mean, you know, it's not as expensive as these two mics that I got, but I got a good deal on it, a bundle, and I don't know. I thought it was going to be fantastic, and it was going to at least be maybe my main mic or at least a third mic. For example, I might have... let's say, for example, I might have Chris Filan from the new House of Brews West Ashley that's going to be opening up hopefully sometime late September, early October. You know, maybe I have him in here talking about House of Brews West Ashley. At the same time, I have Rob in here from House of Brews Mount Pleasant. And we talk about both of those things, how both of them came together, how they mesh, how they work in synergy with each other. So that's why I wanted a third mic in case I have a couple of different guests, which I want to do. I don't want to just have one person sitting across me all the time. I want to have, you know, maybe some multiple guests, different guests that have differing views, and we can have some confrontation and some debate and whatever. And I also wanted to have that third mic, and I guess I'm going to have to ask Fleming to bring out his expensive mic, which is the same brand as these guys, but it's just a higher level of mic for those guys. What kind of mic is this? I don't even know. Does it even matter at this point if I tell you what the name of this mic is? Audio Techniques, maybe? I don't know. So, yeah, I wanted to have that third mic when we do the next Mayor Q&A session next Wednesday, as a matter of fact, in Studio 117 there at Homegrown Brew House, 117 South Main Street. I wanted to have a third mic, like I've mentioned before in the past, to put out in the middle of the crowd, the middle of the people that are posing questions, the audience. That's what, that would be a good name for who those guys are. They're the audience. I wanted to put a mic out there in the middle of the audience so that we could capture the questions a little bit better than we did last time, because we had problems hearing those questions. I told you I had to download a program called Levelator to try and level all the sound that was in that room on that day. It's a big room. There's a lot of travel. Fleming got off mic, the audience was off mic, and I just was very unhappy with the audio. It turned out okay. I mean, it was okay. It was all right. And, you know, I had audio problems last time, and I'll talk about that here in just a second as well. But anyway, I wanted that third mic. So that guy's sitting over there. I'm going to try and figure it out. I'm going to try a different mic, or I'm going to try a different cable. I'm going to try some different hookups and make sure that I need to send it back before I do, because it's really a pain in the ass if I have to send it back. So stay tuned for that. I'll keep you updated maybe on the next episode. This is going to be a special Wednesday episode, as a matter of fact, because I wasn't feeling well last night, and I was going to do this episode last night for the normal Tuesday release, but I did not feel well at all. I went to bed early, and I slept quite a while, and then when I got up, I was groggy, and I just didn't feel like doing it again, so I did not. And I feel like the sound is off on this guy, actually, as well, but it's not. What was I saying? I lost my train of thought, so. Yeah, I was going to do an episode. I didn't. What I did was I recycled an episode talking about Chris Vieland and the House of Brews West Ashley. I recycled an episode from way back, I mean, probably a year ago, maybe even a little bit longer than that. I think it was a year, where we sat down and talked to Chris Vieland, just about various things, about his bartending at the Tin Roof and filling at Coast and working the canning line there at Coast and being a musician and his future plans at that time to open up House of Brews West Ashley. Well, now that has come to fruition, and it's almost there. It's in the works. They're waiting on some red tape to be cut, and it's still got some construction going on, but it's going to be coming up very soon. So I recycled that episode from a year ago just to kind of prep you guys to get ready for the upcoming episode with Chris. And maybe, like I said, Rob from House of Brews West Mount Pleasant might join us as well. So I haven't posed that question to him yet, but I've reached out to Chris today and asked him what he thought, and we'll kind of go from there. So that's what's going on with that. So this will be a special Wednesday release. I'm hopefully going to maybe have somebody come in tomorrow for an episode for Friday. If not, I'll just do an episode myself, which is not a problem whatsoever. Let's open this cider. It's not a beer. Let's open this cider. I still got some of these ciders left. Mark didn't take these guys with him when he was in here last week. But let's open this guy, and then I'm going to go into why I almost quit the podcast last week. And yes, you've heard me say that many times. But yeah, this was almost the end of this podcast. I'm going to use a wine glass, stemless wine glass today for this. Bold Rock IPA, India Pressed Apple. That's what I'm drinking. This is what I had from Mark last week. It's a dry hop cider. I think it had Citra something. Let's look it up. Let's talk about it one more time real quick. That's that guy right there. Let's type in Untappd. Man, got that AC kicking again, and I can hear that fan through the headphones. So, Bold Rock. India Pressed Apple right there, second option. A West Coast-style dry hop cider featuring Aranum, Citra, and Centennial hops to complement the bite of local Granny Smith apples. Bold Rock Cider is out of Virginia. It's a 4.7% ABV. It's got an average rating of 3.74. Not bad. Not bad at all. Let's see if any of my friends have had it here. Let's see. This thing is just not... Excuse me. Just not as good as the phone app. Yeah. My friends Evie and Sherry used to be here in town. They're up in Oak Island now. They both had it just recently. No, this ain't recent. This is December of last year, December of 2018. They had it. It was on there at Lowe's Foods here in Somerville, where I used to work, the beer den. They both gave it a 4.5 and a 4.25, respectively. Robert Roulette, which is another guy that I trust on here. He gave it a 375. Caleb's had it. Greg Knopp. Nope. Knopp? I don't even know how you say his last name. Knopp? Knope? Who knows how you say Greg's name? But he gave it a 375. Emily used to run Cafe Crafts, gave it a 3.5. Just good ratings on here. People are liking it. People were digging it. I thought it was pretty good. Even my buddy Gordon, he drank it back in January of 2016. Damn, this thing's been around for a while. So he gave it a 4.25. I'm not a big fan of ciders, but I enjoyed it. What did I give it last time? I don't even know. Let's see. I gave it a 3.75 as well. So, no, did I? Jesus Christ. I can't do anything on this computer, man. This computer is, yeah, give it a 3.75 on the 16th of August. All right, so are we going to get into this thing or what? So I had Mark Yampolsky. I never did ask him exactly how he says his name. I knew I said I was going to, and I never did get around to it. We talked about so many things. Man, what a fantastic episode. Let's start there. Mark was a fantastic guest. I apologize to him profusely for the sound problems that I had that day, and that's what I'm getting ready to talk about. But fantastic guest. He gave me some great music to load into the podcast. We talked about great stuff. I got to know Mark a lot better than I ever knew him before, and just a great guy. Great stories. I think he had a good time. I think he really enjoyed it. He even gave me a great compliment saying I was a great interviewer and that I did a fantastic job. I hope he just wasn't being nice. But when he left, I went to, as I always do, immediately, I go up to File and I go to Export Audio. And I try and get this audio off of here before anything goes wrong, before the computer reboots for some reason, the power shuts off, whatever. I try and make sure that I save that file immediately. Because if I don't and I lose it, then I've got trouble. I got work to do. And so I hit File. I hit Export. When I hit Export, an error message came up that said something to the effect of another audio program is battling for control in Audacity. Something like that. It wasn't like that at all. But it was something similar to that, that there was two audio sources fighting for Audacity's attention. And then it said at the bottom of that message that some of the audio file may be lost, or some of the audio may be lost, or something to that effect. So I'm like, holy shit, don't tell me that I've lost all the audio on this damn podcast. So I hit OK. It does this thing. It saves. You know, I name it and do all the normal stuff that I normally do. I go back in and I hit File and I hit the open or import that file back into Audacity because I want to go back and listen to it. As I always do, I always export it. I name it as soon as it does this thing and it exports. I'll unplug my headphones. I'll plug my headphone into the Mac here, and that way I can go back and listen to that audio file immediately after I get done. And I adjust the levels, and I maybe take out some of the air noise from the air conditioning or whatever. Anything that I want to do with that audio now, I can manipulate it and do that. Well, I import the file back in to Audacity. I start listening to it. The first 5 or 6 minutes, oh, man. Pitch perfect. I mean, the audio is just amazing. It's so good. You know, I even made sure I told Mark a couple times to pull that mic back into him and get it closer so we could get these levels pitch perfect for Mark's episode. I wanted it to be perfect. I really did. It's been a long time that I've been trying to get Mark in here. And I know he's a stickler with his music and with all the projects that he does, you know, with sound and stuff. So I wanted to make sure it was good. Well, after about 6 minutes worth, what would happen was I would have about a 10 or 15 second block of dialogue, and then it would be a 10 or 15 second block of silence. And then it would pick back up after that silence with the next 10 or 15 seconds, and then 10 or 15 seconds of silence. There was about 20 minutes of that in a row. And then there was a period where everything was normal again. And then there was another slice of the audio that had that same thing, 10 seconds on, 10 seconds off, 10 seconds on, 10 seconds off. Not salvageable. You can't figure out what the hell the conversation is because you're missing pieces of it. So I, at that moment, almost opened up the window over here. I'm on the second floor. I'm in the room above my garage, the frog. I almost opened up the window and tossed every single thing you see on this desk, the mics, the TV, the board, the computer. I almost tossed everything out that damn window. I'm not lying. I'm not exaggerating. I know I say all the time, I don't want to do this podcast and that it's a pain in my ass and blah, 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 and it's pissing me off. This night, man, I mean, smoke was probably coming out of my head. My face was probably beet red. I was about to explode, and I texted a couple of people and said, oh my God, I'm about to lose it. I'm about to throw everything out the window. Fuck this podcast. Forget this shit. This shit, you know, there's always something going wrong. I need help. I can't do this by myself anymore. There's always something that's happening. Every damn episode when I think I've got it perfect and I've got everything figured out, I won't have the battery in the camera, a new battery, a fresh battery in the camera. I won't have wiped the hard drive, which is part of this episode. I'll talk to you about that as well. Or not the hard drive, the flash drive. I have sound issues. The mic doesn't work. I forget to replace the battery in the headphone jack. There's always something going on. Sometimes Audacity just quits recording altogether, and I've got no recording. And then when I export the files, when I'm trying to export and when trying to encode the video or whatever, things happen, I can't, I don't know. It's just, it's a plethora of things that goes on this podcast. And that particular night, man, I was like, you've got to be kidding me. I've lost this entire hour and 30 minutes of audio on this podcast that I thought was pitch perfect and was going to be the best audio I've had so far. You talk about being upset, being mad. Leia knows, don't you, Leia? I was inadvertently taking it out on her, and I apologized. So anyway, I said, okay, just calm down, Brian. The other thing that happened was during the podcast, you know, I had the GoPro set up over here. I had made sure I put a fresh battery in there because I had messed up the last time I had a guest in here, which was Kyle of Charleston Brewery List, and I didn't put a fresh battery in, so the battery died. And I had a space of a video that I had to fill in with just, you know, a logo or what have you. So I made sure this time, Brian, put a damn battery in there. And I've got a checklist, but I feel like I've got the checklist memorized. I guess I don't. So I made sure that I put the mini SD card back into the camera. I said, okay, let me pull it out of my Surface Pro. Let me put it back into the camera. Well, I forgot to format the camera as I normally do, or the SD drive. So there was files from a couple of different things that I had done on that SD drive. And about halfway through the podcast, the conversation with Mark, beep, 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 I hear the camera cut off. And I immediately said, memory's full. So I told Mark, I said, give me a second, man. I apologize. Let's pause for the cause. I'm going to take the drive out, delete some of the files, put it back in so we can continue with the video. So I got that taken care of. That happened during the podcast. So I felt like I handled that very well and I got it taken care of. Not a problem. I was going to be able to just kind of edit a little bit, you know, push that together and it would have been pretty seamless. Well, now I've got no audio to go with it. So luckily I do record on the camera and luckily I did not just say, oh, screw the camera. It went off. I'll plug some JPEGs in there or something or some music or, you know, cover it up somehow. Luckily, I went and replaced the SD card and continued the video because if I hadn't have done that, I wouldn't have any audio for that podcast last week. So all that happened. I'm here at the house. I said, you know what? I'm fuming right now. There's no way I can continue to edit and do this thing and think straight. So I packed up my Mac. I packed up the hard drive that I had everything saved on. I headed out the door and I went to Dog and Duck down the road. And I said, I'm going to go get me a beer. I'm going to get me something to eat. And I'm just going to relax for a minute. I'm going to calm down and I'm going to figure this thing out. I'll bring the computer with me. No big deal. We'll get it all worked out. So I get a dog and duck, order my drink, order some food. I pull out my book bag, the computer here, open it up, bam, get on there. I said, okay, let me import the video files into Audacity. And what happens is it'll convert that, the audio on the video there, convert that into an MP3, and then I can work with it, manipulate it, do whatever. Well, I went to import the audio files or the video files into Audacity so it can convert them. And it says I did not have, it brings me up a message that says I don't have a certain codec that I need to convert, you know, an MPEG, M4 file, movie file. So I'm like, damn it, I've had this problem before. I thought I had fixed it. Let me go in. I went into preferences. I'm not going to go through all the details, but I had to go get a codec and download it and import it into Audacity for it to be able to do its function and do its thing. I did that 3 different times. It would not take. It would say that it was loaded. It walked me through the install, blah, blah, blah. Hit this. Okay. Successful. Nothing. I never could get it to work. So I said, okay. And last time I remembered, I thought I saw something that in the newer versions of Audacity for Mac, that it was that codec was already configured into the Audacity program itself, and that you didn't have to re-download it anymore. Well, apparently you did. But I remembered that from somewhere, and I said, okay, well, why don't we do this? Let's, taking some deep breaths, I'm meditating, I'm trying to stay calm. And I said, okay, let's uninstall Audacity on this Mac. Let's reinstall it, see if, the latest and greatest version of Audacity, let's see if that fixes it. Nope, did not fix it. Okay, well, now that we've got a fresh version of Audacity in there, let's reinstall this codec in there. I think it's called FFmpeg, FF something. Let's reinstall that into it and see if that works. Well, guess what? That did not work either. So I slammed the computer down, and I almost picked it up and flung it across the restaurant there at Dog and Duck. But I saw a bunch of people over there, kids, families, whatever. I said, they don't need that hassle. I'm not gonna involve them in my freaking crisis. So I did not throw it, but I closed it. I put it back in my bag, and I said, oh, my God. And had a couple beers. I got something to eat. I said, okay, all right, just calm down. When you get home, you've got another computer, Surface Pro, that you know for a fact will convert those video files to an audio file for you, and then you can get to work. Well, 6 a.m. rolls around. We got done with the podcast at like 7:30 p.m. 6 a.m. the next morning rolls around. I'm finally done. I'm finally done with editing, uploading. Probably going on way too long about this, but I had finally got the video files converted to audio. I'd imported them. I had to splice that audio together. I had to adjust the levels as best I could. You know, the camera was way over here. We were talking. It picked up quite nicely, but I still couldn't elevate it without getting a bunch of distortion. Because I'm not an audio guy. I'm not a video guy. I'm not either one of those guys. I'm learning to be. I'm trying to be. You know, YouTube and Google are my best friends. I haven't had any formal training on any of this. None of it. So I did the best I could with the audio. Well, then I had the problem with the video where there was a gap in the video. So luckily, the audio that I had recorded through, you know, all the gear here, the mics and the board, that piece of audio was intact, where there was a gap in between the video where I had to cut it off and wipe the card and put it back in. So I was able to splice that piece out, plug it into the middle, make it one big audio to match the video. I got it out. I was not happy with it whatsoever. Everybody says it was great, that they enjoyed it, that it sounded fine. I disagree wholeheartedly, 100%. It should have been 300 times better on the sound than it was. Oh, it still pisses me off. I mean, it's almost a week later, and I'm still highly upset about it. I know I just got to move on. It's done. It's out there. People are listening to it. People are liking it, responding to it, sharing it, all those good things. So, you know, I just got to move on. I really like things to go like I want them to go. And it's always something, man. So that was that. So 6 a.m. the next morning, I finally got it all together. I got it pieced together, Frankenstein together, as I would say. Excuse me again. Jeez. I got it all together. I got it encoded, through Premiere. I got it exported. I got it uploaded to YouTube. I got it uploaded to Podbean, all those things. And I pushed it out by 7 a.m. on time the next day. But it took me till 6 a.m. to get that all together. Long story to tell you all that. But I felt you guys should know the pains that I go through to put this show together for you. And I don't want sympathy. I really don't. I just want you to know that when I put a product out for you guys, that I've worked hard on it, that I'm not just sitting here, you know, doing a 30-minute episode and then 30 minutes later I've got it uploaded and it's ready to go for the next day. No, it takes a lot of work, and I hope you guys appreciate the love that I have for this show and the love that I have for the information that I try and get out to you guys, and that I'm working hard. A lot of people say they're working hard for the money. Well, I'm working hard for no money. And I'm not saying I wish I had money, I need money, but I'm just letting you guys know. So that's the Mark episode. I almost quit. I almost threw everything out the window and said, I'm done. Forget all of it. It's all broken now. I can't even do an episode. I would have figured out a way just to do it on my phone or whatever. I would have continued, but let's move on. So speaking of podcasts, my mouth's a little dry. Pardon me. Speaking of podcasts, there's a new podcast on the market called Wings Weekly. It is hosted by Mr. Joshua Jarman. He's been on the show a couple times, one time here in the studio, and then one time we did an episode in his van out of his house. And that was fantastic. That was a great time. That was the first time that I'd kind of gone remote for real. And I did it all on my own. I thought it turned out really well. You can check it out. It's on YouTube. It's on Podbean. It's on all the places. I think it was called In a van Down by the River, I think was that episode. I think you'll like it. It was unique. But anyway, he started a podcast. This week was his second episode. Last week was his pilot, where he kind of explained what the show was about, what his expectations were, what he was trying to accomplish, blah, blah, blah. And this week I actually had a guest on there, and guess who the guest was? The first guest that he had on there was Mr. Caleb Quire. Yes, the original guy for this podcast, Craft Conversations. He created the logos. He created the show itself. You know, it was kind of a collaboration of thoughts, but he kind of came up with the idea for Craft Conversations, and I've kind of run with it. And Caleb is doing his own thing now. He's got a thing called the Brewery Life, or it might just be Brewery Life, maybe not The Brewery Life, where he sits down with Oak Road Brewery on a monthly basis, and they talk just brewery mishaps, brewery life, what beers they're brewing, what's the mishaps that are going on, what shows are coming up, what events they have going on, whatever. They may have some guests in there as well. I'm not sure if it's just going to always be just Ben and Brian and Caleb. I'm sure they're going to bring some other people into the mix. If it continues to go on, I've only seen one episode so far. I listened to it. There's no video. And there's no video on Wings Weekly at the moment either. But anyway, Joshua had Caleb Quire on there, and they talked quite a bit about what Caleb's doing these days with the Bait Cat Studios, and with he's still doing the CQ Work stuff. He's doing the pet portraits. He's doing house paintings. He's doing some block printing now on T-shirts and doing some T-shirt work, tank tops, tote bags, those type things. He helped do a mural there at Coastal Coffee Roasters. So a lot of stuff that Caleb's got going on. It was pretty entertaining. pretty enlightening. I learned some new things that are going on with both of those guys. And, you know, both of those guys are doing well. They're doing new things, and they're trying to contribute to the art scene here in Somerville and trying to, the same thing I'm doing and the same thing Fleming Moore is doing, the same thing, hell, everybody's doing. Visit Somerville, Somerville Dream. All these entities are trying to bring the town of Somerville together and trying to showcase local artists and musicians and businesses and entrepreneurs and just people in general. And I think it's a fantastic thing. We're going to collaborate hopefully one day. I know Joshua has asked me if I would be on his show eventually. So that'll be upcoming on Wings Weekly. So follow those guys on Podbean. I know is the main thing that they're on right now. They probably are still waiting on approval to get on iTunes and Spotify and some other places maybe. But I know Podbean for sure. So Wings Weekly, go out there and check it out, his two episodes that he's put out so far. And then also go to go to Podbean and check out Brewery Life and listen to that first episode with Caleb and Brian and Ben from Oak Road Brewing Company. And hopefully I'll be, you know, I want to sit down with Caleb again eventually. I've mentioned it to him multiple times, and it just hadn't been the right time yet for us to get together, but I'd love to talk to Caleb either on his new podcast or to sit down and have him come back in and have a return here on Craft Conversations and just see what is going on and what I've been missing for the past year that we've been apart from each other. Let's see here. What other notes do I have? We've already talked about recycling Chris Filan this morning or yesterday for Tuesday's episode. We'll get him in here eventually. The new location, from what I see when I follow him on Instagram, the place is coming along nicely. They were putting the bar in. I think I saw the bathrooms going in, everything being plumbed. A lot of the woodwork being completed before they start laying down the bar and some different things. All the rooms have been, you know, sectioned out and drywalled and throwing some, What's the paint you put on before you paint? I know all you guys are out there screaming it to me. What's the paint you put on? The primer. I've seen, you know, the primer and stuff up on the walls. So it's coming along. Like I said, end of September, early October, hopefully that thing's going to be opening. He told me he may not be able to get with me until after they open, which will be fine. You know, once they open, I told him I'd like to bring all the equipment and actually do the conversation there at the West Ashley House of Brews location. I think that'd be fun. I like doing the remote stuff. I think it gives people a better view for the show if you're watching the YouTube videos, you know. So that's going to be coming up sometime in the near future. Hopefully, maybe September. It might not be till October. So, but that's coming. What else? You know, mainly I just wanted to put an episode out and talk about my mishap from last week. That was the biggest thing, but I am waiting on, I bought some supplements from Onnit. If you haven't heard of Onnit, let me pull it up. I'll tell you about Onnit. I listen to Joe Rogan all the time. You guys know this. That's my favorite podcast. That's my go-to. If I'm going to listen to a podcast, I'm checking him first to see if he's got a new episode. And I've been an Onnit fan for a long time. I haven't bought anything from those guys in a while. You know, supplements aren't cheap, man, and sometimes I just don't feel like buying any supplements, but I went and I said, you know what, I've kind of put on a little bit of weight, I've been on and off of the keto train, I haven't been very disciplined, I haven't been working out at all. You know, I'll do some yard work here and there, I'll work at Homegrown and, you know, on my feet, walking about 4 miles per shift or whatever, but I haven't done a true workout in a long time, and I told myself I need to get back into it. So what I've done is I've gone to Onnit.com, and I've had these supplements before, and they worked fantastically, fabulously, worked well. It's called Total Human. It's a convenient day and night pack, complete with essential vitamins, minerals, herbs, and amino acids to optimize yourself with ease.
Let's see what else it says here. Better than multivitamins. Let's pull that up. Let's just go through a couple things. No shortage of options for vitamins and supplements, but which ones do you need? Total Human is a complete reimagining of the daily multivitamin, combining many of our best-in-class formulas into a simple and effective all-in-one product. Not simply one pill. Total Human is a dense, rich dose of a myriad of earth-grown nutrients and clinically studied ingredients specifically balanced to support the brain, mood, energy, bones, immune system, joint health, and more. These formulas come in convenient day and night packs, each aimed at building you up while you work and working while you sleep. There's no easier way to get optimized. So that's what I got coming in. As soon as it comes in, I'm going to jump on this, and it's on, man. It's a 30-day pack that I got coming in, a day and night pack. It's going to get me optimized. I'm going to get back into some hardcore workouts. I'm going to get back into full-blown ketosis, and we're going to see what kind of transformation we're going to do in 30 days. And I'm serious this time. I've said it a couple times. I've kind of gone off the rails. You know, life happens, whatever. I'm going to get back into it, and we're going to see some big stuff going on. The day and night packs travel with you, giving you the optimum effects when and where you need them. In just a few seconds a day, you can easily and efficiently provide your body with what it needs to thrive. Whether you're at work, working out, or otherwise doing what you love, the Total Human Day Pack supports your focus, energy, endurance, and general wellness to keep you on point and performing effortlessly at your best. The ingredients for the Day Pack, they have Alpha Brain in it, which is a nootropic, helps your brain, memory, and focus. It has Shroom Tech support, which is for your energy and endurance. It has Strong Bone, which is supports your bone health, and a Total Human B Complex. And then we go into the Night Pack. Everything about your physical, mental, and emotional states is different in the morning than in the evening. Just like how you wouldn't drink coffee to fall asleep, the nutrients and ingredients that assist you at work or working out are not the same nutrients you take to relax and unwind at the end of the day. The Total Human Night Pack helps you turn off the lights with a peaceful smile and nourishes your body with the raw materials it needs to wake up feeling at your peak potential. So what it's got in there is their new mood, which is a mood and relaxation supplement. Virutech is a antioxidant support. And then it's got a key mineral appropriately named and packed with calcium, boron, magnesium, iodine to support bone and overall body health. So that's what's going on, dudes and dudettes. Oh, and it's also got some krill oil in there, so you get your essential fatties, omega-3s, DHA, all that kind of stuff. It's got some spirulina and some chlorella in there as well, which is some green superfoods, and then a few more mushrooms as well, and some turmeric. Just, man, all the stuff, and it comes all in just an easy-to-use pack. You don't have to go out and buy all these separate supplements and piece them together. They piece it together for you and put them all in a pack for you. You pull out your day pack, bam, you slide it open, rip it open, pop it in your mouth, drink about 20 ounces of water to get yourself rehydrated in the morning, and you're gone. You're on. You do your thing during the day. At night, you come home, you're ready to relax and go to sleep and get a good night's rest. You pop the night pack open, bam, throw it down your mouth, maybe throw another 20 ounces of water down, and you're done. Two packs, one in the morning, one at night, and you're optimized. And as a previous customer, a couple times, I fully support it and I fully promote it, and it's going to work for you. So get out there, onit.com. And I wish I had a discount code for you. I think, if you go on there for the first time, you'll get a pop-up that's going to give you 10% off. Also, if you're a first responder or military, you can verify your ID, and you'll get 15% off of your order, so you can do that. You may find a code out there you might be able to go to, hell, I'm sure there's a discount through Joe Rogan, but it's probably, you know, just a 10 or 15% as well. So it's not going to be much difference as far as a discount goes. But so it's time to get optimized, guys. Time to get back on track. That's all I got to say. I'm going to sign off. Hope you guys have a good rest of your week, and hope you enjoyed and went out and listened to Chris's episode from last year, and hope you enjoy listening to this episode, and we'll put out a new one as soon as we can. I got some guests that want to get in here. I just have to get them scheduled, and we're going to sit down and talk to some people. So we're going to keep on keeping on, guys and gals, and whatever else, you know. I'm starting to say folks nowadays instead of saying guys or gals or whatever, because, you know, the whole climate is shifting in many ways. So anyway, have a good night, folks, and we will talk to you soon.